Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 5.5, Problem 16. This is Section 5.5, Problem number 16. It says the statistics class has 19 students consisting of 12 women and 7 men. You're interested in how many 6-player volleyball teams can be made from the students in this class. So they have 19 students altogether, men and women. So part A, how many teams can be made with any mix of men and women? So you have 19 students. You're going to pick 6 of them for a volleyball team. How many different ways can that happen? Well, how can we figure that out? So basically, we have 3 different formulas from this section that we learned. There's permutation, combination, and multiplication principle. So essentially, it's got to be one of those. Permutation, there's no repeated items, and the different orders count as a different answer. Well, if you have the same 6 players, you put them in a different order, it's the same volleyball team. Combination is the one to go with, because there should be no repeats. I can't be on the team 4 times. I can only be on once. You can't have a repeated player. And the different orders don't matter, because it's still the same volleyball team. So we will use the combination formula. That's the key. And now, if you can mix the men and women any way you want, you have 19 things to choose from. You're going to choose 6 of them. So what we want is 19 combination 6. So to figure that out, you have to remember the combination formula. N combination R is N factorial over N minus R in parentheses factorial, and you have times R factorial in front of the parentheses. Now, the larger number is the N, which for this one is 19, and the smaller number is the 6. So now as I fill this in, I'm going to have 19 factorial on the top, 6 factorial in front of the parentheses, and just to save myself a little room in the parentheses, 19 minus 6. 19 minus 6 is 13 factorial. Now, if you do that out, again, just to say, well, this is going to take a lot of room, so I know that the answer is 27,132 if you do 19 combination 6, if you do out the factorials, cancel the stuff that you can. Multiply what's left that didn't cancel, you're going to have 27,132 different volleyball teams you can make out of a class of only 19 students. So, B, how many teams can be made if all the players are women? So only women on the team. Well, there's 12 women in the class. So you have 12 people to choose from. You're going to choose 6. So, again, it's combination. You can't have a repeat. You can't have the same woman on the team 2 or 3 times. And the order doesn't matter. If you have 6 players, you rearrange them in a different order. It's the same volleyball team. So, same formula. N combination R is N factorial over R factorial times in parentheses N minus R factorial. The larger value is the N, which would be the 12. And the smaller value, the R, is the 6. So as I fill this in, N factorial would be 12 factorial. And the R is 6, so I would have 6 factorial. In the parentheses, N minus R, N is 12, R is 6. 12 minus 6 would give me another 6 factorial. So let's see if I can actually fit this one in. So on the top, 12 factorial is 12 times 11 times 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And then in the denominator, you'll have 6 factorial times 6 factorial again. So the first 6 factorial is 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. And the second 6 factorial is the same thing, 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Which can all be multiplied out and reduced, but let's at least cancel 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, top and bottom. And then you can cancel off a lot of the stuff in the denominator. So I have a 6 in the denominator, 12 on the top. 6 goes in the 6 once, 6 goes in the 12 twice. 5 and 10 will reduce. 5 goes in the 5 once, it goes in the 10 twice. 4 will reduce with the 8. 4 goes into 4 once, goes into 8 twice. 3, the 3 and the 9 will reduce. 3 goes into 3 once, 3 goes into 9 3 times. And then the last 2 will cancel one of the 2's in the top. And if you multiply out what's left, 2 times 11 times 2 times 3 times 7, let's see what I get for that. That would multiply out to 924. So if you have 12 women in the class, there's 924 different ways you can choose 6 of them to make up a volleyball team. So now the next part of the question, what is the probability that a randomly chosen volleyball team would be made up of only female players? Well, there are 924 all-female teams out of 27,132 teams that are possible altogether. So if you do that division, that's not something I can reduce easily. 924 divide by 27,132 is 0.03405527. That's about a 3.5, a little less than 3.5% probability that if you just randomly pick a team, it'd have only women on it. Don't start it up yet, hang on. Okay, let me know when.
In 3, 2, 1.
Part D, how many teams can be made if all the players are men? So in this class of 19, there were 12 women, 7 men. So you have 7 men to choose from, and again we use the combination formula, and you're choosing 6 for the volleyball team. So again, the combination formula, n combination r equals n factorial over r factorial times in parentheses n minus r, close the parentheses, factorial. So the n is the larger number, which is 7, and the 6 is the smaller number, the r. So if I fill this in, the top n factorial would be 7 factorial. Underneath in the denominator, r factorial would be 6 factorial. In the parentheses, n minus r, let me just do it right underneath here, 7 minus 6, that's just going to be 1 factorial. So as I do this out, I can see it's going to be 7. 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 is the 7 factorial. 6 factorial is 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, and the 1 factorial on the end is just 1. And again, you can multiply all of that and then reduce it, which would be a big task, or you can just cancel 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 on the top and in the bottom, and you're just left with a 7. So there are 7 different teams you can make with only male players. And then E asks, what is the probability that a randomly selected volleyball team would be made up of only male players? Well, there are 7 teams that are only male players out of 27,132 teams possible altogether. So that I would need a calculator for. You're going to divide that. So 7 divided by 27,132. Is 0.0002579, and it goes on, so almost impossible. It's very, very low probability that you would find a team of only men. It could happen, but almost impossible. So part F, how many teams can be made of 3 men and 3 women? So now this is going to combine two rules. We're going to combine our combinations, and we're going to combine the multiplication principle with it. So basically what I have here is a multiple step process. The first step is figure out how many different options I have for only men, men only, volleyball teams, and then figure out how many different ways I can have women only volleyball teams. and multiply those two numbers together. So for the men only teams, there are 7 men to choose from. I want to figure out how many different ways I can choose 3 of them. For the women only volleyball teams, I have 12 women to choose from, and I want to figure out how many different ways I can choose 3 of them. So what I have to do is do this combination formula for 7 combination 3, do the next combination formula for 12 combination 3, take the two answers that I get and multiply them together. So off to the side, let me do the first 7 combination 3. 7 combination 3, I'm going to run it through the formula. N factorial, R factorial, N minus R in parentheses factorial. So the N would be the 7. I'm going to have 7 factorial over R factorial is 3 factorial. In the parentheses, N minus R, 7 minus 3 will be 4 factorial. Now I'll get an answer for that. 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 is the 7 factorial on the top. The denominator, 3 factorial, is 3 times 2 times 1. 4 factorial is 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So let's cancel 4 times 3 times 2 times 1 in the top and in the bottom. I can multiply what's left and reduce, but 3 times 2 times 1 multiplies to 6. So essentially I have a 6 in the bottom. I also have a 6 in the top. And I'm just left with 7 times 5. So 7 times 5, 35. There are 35 different ways I can have three male players out of 7. It's 35 different ways I can choose 3 out of a group of 7. Now, how about the all women groupings of 3? So it's going to be the same process, except I'm going to have 12 combination 3. And again, the N is the bigger number, the 12, and the R is the smaller one. So N factorial will be 12 factorial. R factorial will be 3 factorial. Then N minus R, in this case 12 minus 3, will be 9 factorial. So if I do this out, 12 factorial is 12 times 11 times 10 times 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. Then in the denominator, 3 factorial, 3 times 2 times 1. 9 factorial, it's going to wind up canceling a lot of stuff in the numerator. 9 factorial is 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 times 4 times 3 times 2 times 1. So the 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 in the top and bottom can be canceled. And I'm left with 3 times 2 times 1 in the bottom, 12 times 11 times 10 in the top. And I can reduce that. 3 times 2 times 1 is basically 6. So 6 in the bottom will reduce that 12 down to a 2. So I have 2 times 11 times 10. 2 times 11 is 22. And then 22 times 10 is 220. So now I can multiply 35 different ways I can choose 3 men out of 7 times 220 different ways I can choose 3 women out of 12. So if I multiply that, 35 times 220 equals 7,700. There's 7,700 different teams that can be made of 3 men and 3 women. And the last question, what is the probability that a randomly chosen volleyball team will be made up of 3 men and 3 women? Well, there are 7,700 different ways I can have a volleyball team with 3 men and 3 women out of 27,132 different possible volleyball teams altogether from this class of 19 people. And if I divide that out, 7,700 divided by 27,132 is 0.283797. It goes on a little more than a 28% probability that your volleyball team, if chosen at random, would have 3 men and 3 women.